Welcome. My name is Bob Tickleman. I'm a Microsoft technical trainer, and I'm excited to be your guide on this AZ-500 Microsoft Azure Security Technologies. We're on learning path two, looking now at module number three, where we're going to focus specifically on the public access controls that we're going to be able to use to build on the previous two of looking at the virtual networking and then the private access. We're going to look at all the public access versions. So focusing on public access to the Azure resources, we want to take a look at TLS, or the Transport Layer Security, and the App Service Plan Management that we have available to us. When you take a look at App Service Plans, we mentioned in a previous recording, is a way for you to be able to take your applications that have traditionally been on premises and put on virtual machines that you would then have to manage and secure so that your application could be on a secure environment. With the App Service Plans, you're now not having to manage that infrastructure component. So whether they be Windows servers or Linux, they are patched and maintained and secured by Microsoft and offered to you as a service. So TLS, or the Transport Layer Security, is the way that you're going to be able to manage and access to the application's resources. And you can still take a look at how the servers are going to secure the application environment, but really you're worried about locking down the application itself. And so they give you a number of tools that are going to be available for you to manage the application layer and TLS. Other ways that you have to now take that application that you might make publicly available. It might be an internal application or a publicly available application. We will look at some of those more traditional ways of firewalls, and we'll take a look at things called an application gateway and a thing called a CDN, or content delivery network, and a feature called Azure Front Door. Now, this slide gets into a traditional firewall. In a previous recording, I've talked about having a firewall in place in that public-private ingress-egress. So any place you have that public exposed IP address going to a privately exposed address internal to your applications, anytime you have that, you may want to have something more than an NSG, the network security group, to block that traffic. You need to do that deep packet inspection. In that other recording, we talked about there's different versions. You can have a Microsoft Azure firewall, which is built and managed by Microsoft, with all the same features you would expect from third party. Or if you have already an existing environment that you've got a number of firewalls across your infrastructure already, whether it be on premises, and you wanted to extend that management plane to Azure, every single major manufacturer of firewalls have an appliance that's available in Azure that you could deploy for that. But you want it in that public-private, and it still needs to be part of a network segment. So this diagram doesn't do it justice from a network perspective. I'm going to do maybe a different diagram in a few minutes. But all of those features down the left-hand part of the slide talk about the capabilities of what a firewall is going to provide for you. Now, just to be clear, in the bottom right-hand corner, it says traffic is denied by default. It's technically not accurate. Traffic isn't allowed by default. And so, much like a secure by default, if you don't have access to something, you don't have access to it. You don't need to deny it. And the reason I'm trying to be clear on this is denies that override and allow. If you put a deny in, it will override and allow. But if you don't have access, you don't have to deny it, because you can then run into problems by denying everything. And I've seen that happen. People have I deny all traffic, because that's what Microsoft says, deny all traffic, and then I'm going to try allow something. The deny happens first. You're not going to gain access to it. So by not allowing traffic, for all intents and purposes, is that secure by default. You want to then allow something, and then what you might want to use is a deny to prove the rule and not be the rule. So just a highlight on that bottom right-hand side. So firewalls, they should be used as that public-private ingress-egress for the deep packet inspection, the SSL offloading, all that stuff that you couldn't get from a traditional NSG. Now, you'll see on the right-hand side, they talk about traffic into some of those VNets, because a firewall has to exist within a subnet itself. It has to be deployed to a network segment, and then through VNet peering, you can gain access to other resources. When we take a look at global deployments of your resources, remember we have 60 plus, I think 68 as of the time of this recording, regions around the world. So an application gateway is a regionally based way to manage traffic into or out of an app environment at a region. So an application gateway kind of acts as a software firewall. It also acts as an application load balancer. It provides a couple of different features. So an application gateway, whether it be for an app service plan or even apps that you might be hosting in a traditional manner on virtual machines, an application gateway provides that public-private ingress egress. And that's what you're seeing on that dark triangle or diamond on the far left-hand side. The application gateway can take the inbound traffic. It provides that front-end traffic management feature. It also provides some application or web application firewall features that it can now route traffic inside of that region to specific endpoints. So maybe you've got a commercial facing and a retail facing part of your application, and you could route them different way. You could have different IP address or different URL names that you might route one to one name and run to another. There's all sorts of ways to work with the application gateway to provide both firewall and that traffic management piece. So in your Microsoft Cloud Security benchmark, the configurations of those application gateways are going to be important to manage, just like you would the firewall. So think of this as an extension or a different type that is going to do some of that security component as well as the load management features for in-region routing of the traffic. Now, when you start to go beyond a region, so we've looked at the applications in an app service plan or a traditional deployment that exists within a region, I put an application gateway in front of that to manage the traffic into it from the public-private ingress egress. When I start looking at potentially a multi-region deployment, so now I've got my application deployed in multiple regions, I need to be able to shape the traffic globally. Now we have two options. We're not going to cover one of them. The original feature was a thing called Traffic Manager, and it really wasn't there for a security perspective. You know, it was a DNS routing capability, so we don't want to get into it. It's still there, still can use it, but when you take a look at Azure Front Door as a relatively new service in the last couple of years, it is also now including a feature of the CDN or the Content Delivery Network. So we used to have a separate component for that. Now we merged the two of them together, and I would strongly recommend looking at Azure Front Door as a tool, and now it provides a global routing capability where application gateways are regionally based, and in a layered approach, you may have a Azure Front Door that does your global routing, and then you pass that off to an application gateway into the region that it is picked that is best suited based around the shaping traffic that you've configured it for to shape traffic. So maybe, you know, in India, I got to ship people coming from India go there. Mexico goes to a Mexican region. North America goes to a US region, Germany. So all that capability to manage it on a global scale. Now, if you only have a single region deployment, there's no reason to put an Azure Front Door in front of that. You could just have the traffic go to the application gateway for that region. So just looking at that layered approach, application gateways on a per region basis. And just because you have Front Door doesn't mean you have to move past the application gateway. You still might want that depending on the resources that are deployed within the region. But take a look at that layered approach, global routing and management and security done through the Front Door, regionally based routing and traffic management is done through the application gateway, and then the app services looking at TLS to secure that communication. When you take a look at the web application firewall, which is a component of the apps, the application gateway, it provides that firewall feature, that traditional, you know, blocking of traffic, deep packet inspection, SSL offloading. All of those features are now available through the application firewall feature of the application gateway service that you would put in front of it. So you're seeing that more traditional firewall configuration. So do I need a traditional firewall in here? In this case, I would say probably not, because it's going to handle that public-private ingress egress feature that I've referred to that you might want to consider a firewall for, but the application firewall as part of the application Gateway is going to provide that capability. Azure also provides a distributed denial of service, or DDoS, protection. There's a free version that's standard for everybody. There's also an elevated premium service that you can get additional features. But one of the nice things about DDoS and on a global scale in Azure, we have, and we'll be showing you in the final recording for this series, we'll take a look at a feature called Azure Sentinel. And so monitoring the entirety of Azure, DDoS are that denial service where people are trying to consume so many resources at your entry points that it becomes unavailable for your regular traffic that you're working with. So we could actually monitor for that traffic. It's there by default, but you may want to take a look at the elevated features of the premium version of the DDoS protection that's available for you. And again, it can be monitored, tracked, and controlled through your Microsoft Cloud Security Benchmark and then managed through Windows Defender for Cloud. So there's a quick recording on the different options that are available for you on a global basis, taking a look at public-private access to the resources, either on a per-region basis or a global capability using firewalls, using application gateways, and using the Azure Front Door service. So that's it for this recording. I look forward to seeing you at a future recording.